Hello, fellow bookquesters. It is I, Aaron the Bookquester. So today, I have this great book, Steve Jobs, The Man Who Thought Different, one of the best biographies that I have ever read. This biography is by Karen Blumenthal, and let's get right on to it. Normally, I don't like biographies. I mean, I like fantasy way better, but this biography, I loved it. Why? Because this biography was about Steve Jobs, the man who thought different, the founder of Apple, Next, and Pixar. And he was a famous man, but many people didn't know that he was sometimes he was a sarcastic, narcissistic, or whatever, you know, self-involved, into himself. And he was just a really annoying person sometimes, and he was short-tempered, he was annoying to all his relatives, and his social skills, 0%. And people remember him as the inventor, the one who made the iPad, the founder of Apple, and this beautiful Apple logo, he so hardly perfected Apple. With a byte out of it, like the computer bytes, you know, megabytes, gigabytes, that byte, it's a pun, and it's kind of perfect, and that logo is still on our iPads today. Beautiful. And Apple, and Steve Jobs, he was annoying. When he was young, he used to take drugs, and he was a very annoying man. And he also, did you know that he was fired by Apple? Well, he had a new dude that could help him balance out the Apple industry, the guy who had made Pepsi. And with that guy, Steve Jobs, the business prospered until the point where the two started blaming each other for a recent loss. And then the bad guy, I mean the dude who used to run, you know, Pepsi, he kicked Steve Jobs out of the Apple industry, and Steve Jobs, he was hurt. He called that guy a bozo, one of their favorite words that he used to call all his staff members when he was angry or frustrated or whatever he was feeling. No one can tell except him, you know. And after that little ordeal, he made Next, another company like Apple that made hardware and tablets, PCs, phones. Well, those things weren't very good those days. And then Apple started falling apart. And finally, the director of Apple that, you know, was actually the director of Pepsi. I mean, come on. How does the drink Pepsi, burp, commune with this thing? This thing. One of the most intelligent devices on this earth. These things are more powerful than the computers that was used to be used to send astronauts to the moon. That's a simple fact. And a director of Pepsi, a complete bozo, was running Apple. Steve Jobs had to come in. And Apple, knowing that it was falling apart, they bought Next. And when those two combined, they bought Next for a ridiculously high price. And that ridiculous high price, it wasn't high at all. Because with Next, they were getting the founder of Next too, Steve Jobs. And the returning theme, well, that was so hilarious. Well, it's one of the favorite parts of my book, and I think it shows what kind of man Steve Jobs is. A kind of humorous man too. So, he was like, he entered, and he was like, "So, what's wrong with this place?" And the couple staffs tried to answer. And after a couple answers, he's like, "Yeah, the product." And then, "What's wrong with the product?" No one answered. And he's like, "Yeah, that's right, the product suck." I mean, you can tell what kind of man Steve Jobs is. And I think by reading this biography, I learned that no one is perfect, even, and the geniuses could be the outcast of the school, and later on, when they grow up, they might become a man like Steve Jobs. And what I also didn't know was that the two geniuses, Bill Gates and Steve Jobs, they were frenemies. I mean, they used to compete with each other because Microsoft vs. Apple, you know, it still goes on today. And when he was making Macintosh, Bill Gates made Windows, and it was like almost exact copy of the new computer that Steve Jobs was working on, and Steve Jobs went absolutely mad. And, well, I think Steve Jobs was a really good man. He died of cancer later on, at pretty young age for that era. And Steve Jobs, he was a great man, a genius inventor, a very annoying person, a scathing commentist, a completely annoying perfectionist until the end. And he was Steve Jobs. Great book, guys. Read it. Know all about Steve Jobs. And like always, your book quester and the book quester.